Hello friends, I am Prakash Labhane, Assistant Professor in ASC College Chopra, and today I am going to discuss molecular vibrations and IR spectroscopy. So in order to understand IR spectroscopy, we must know about the vibrations. What is a vibration in a molecule? When IR light interacts with the molecule, there could be certain vibrations. These vibrations are of two types, one is stretching vibration and another is bending vibration. In case of stretching vibration, the bond angle will remain same, while in case of bending vibration, bond angle will change. These stretching vibrations are again classified into two categories, while bending vibrations are classified into four categories. We will discuss these vibrations details in next slide. Can vibration change the dipole moment of the molecule? Yes. In case of asymmetrical stretching, there could be a change of dipole moment, and so there could be the that molecule could be the IR active one. What wavelength of electromagnetic radiation is involved in causing vibration in molecules? So this is very important. So about 2500 to 15000 nanometer is required to vibrate the bonds present in the organic molecules. If you convert that nanometer into centimeter inverse, then it is about 4000 to 650 centimeter inverse. The region of infrared that is most exposed. So you can see that the region is about 4000 to 650 centimeter inverse is very important one. And this region is divided into two parts. One is functional group region and another is fingerprint region. The functional group region lies from 4000 to 1500 nanometer, while fingerprint region lies from 1500 to 650 nanometer one. So why this region is known as functional group region, 1500 to 4000 one? Because most of the functional groups get vibrated in this region. Let's see that NH, OH, this is the region, H attached to hetero atoms get vibrated in this region, while this is the triple bond region that is about 2300 to 2000 centimeter inverse, and this is the double bond region that is about 1500 to 1800 centimeter inverse. How much movement occurs in the vibration of carbon-carbon single bond? Stretching vibration, if there is a stretching vibration one, you can see that if the bond length is about 154 picometer, then the length get increases by means of 10 picometer. In case of bending vibration, you can see that the bond angle will change by means of 4 degree. Okay. So this is the stretching vibration. You can see that it is divided into two parts. One is symmetrical stretching, another is anti-symmetric stretching. So in case of symmetric stretching, the bond get elongated in the same direction, while in case of asymmetric stretching, you can see one bond get elongated while one bond get compressed, and the bond angle will remain same. Okay, so this is the bending vibrations. There are four types of bending vibration: scissoring, rocking, wagging and twisting. So these are the two in plane vibrations. This one is the scissoring, this one is the wagging. These are the another two bending vibrations, and these occur in out of plane. You can see this is the wagging and this is the twisting one. So the ideas about vibration will be clear from this slide. These are the symmetrical stretching, this one is the symmetrical stretching, this one is the anti-symmetrical stretching. These are the stretching vibrations, and you can see that in case of these, the both bonds get elongated, while in case of anti-symmetrical stretching, one bond get elongated while one another get compressed. So this is the scissoring one, bending vibration, this is rocking, this is wagging, and this is twisting. So these are the vibrations, and the idea about the vibration is very much clear from this slide. IR masses, atoms and springs. So as you know very well about the Hooke's law, according to Hooke's law, you can see that vibrational frequency is directly proportional to the strength of bond. At the same time, the vibrational frequency is inversely proportional to reduced mass. So this is very much clear. For stretching vibration, more vibrational frequency is required, while for bending vibration, less vibrational frequency is required. Now let us discuss about IR stretching frequencies up to 100 atoms. Okay, what does the frequency depends on? You can see vibrational frequencies, as I told you earlier, is directly proportional to the strength of bond, and it is inversely proportional to reduced mass. If the mass is greater, obviously less vibrational frequency is required, and if the strength is greater, more vibrational frequency is required. So in case of single bond, if you compare two bonds, single bond and double bonds, obviously double bond will require more vibrational frequency as it has greater strength. And while in case of atoms, if there is a bigger atom one, smaller atoms one, smaller atoms will require more vibrational frequency, while bigger atoms will require small vibrational frequency. IR stretching frequencies, what do they depend on? Directly on the strength of bond bonding between the two atoms, as I told you earlier, inversely on the reduced mass of two atoms. Okay. Frequency will increase with increase in bond. Obviously, it will decrease with increase with decrease in mass. Examples of stretching frequencies and correlation with bond strength. You can see that if there are three bonds, one is carbon-carbon, single bond, carbon-carbon, double bond, carbon-carbon, triple bond, no doubt, the bond strength will increase from carbon-carbon, single bond to carbon-carbon, double bond, and from carbon-carbon, double bond to carbon-carbon, triple bond. So this is the bond strength. You can see that it is about 350 for carbon-carbon, single bond, 600 for carbon-carbon, double bond, and 840 for carbon-carbon, triple bond in kilojoules per mole. So bond order is here. 1 for carbon-carbon single bond, 2 for this one, and 3 for carbon-carbon triple bond. So vibrational frequency will also increase because the strength is increases. So it is increases from 1000 to 2200 centimeter inverse. And this will occur for the this will be the same for reduced mass. Which should have higher stretching frequencies? Now let us take these three molecules, CO, CO plus, and CO negative. So as you know very well, higher the bond order, stronger will be the bond, and more vibrational frequency will be required to stretch that bond. So let us find out which one have greater frequency. So obviously we have to find out which one is having greater bond order. So here is the carbon oxygen one. We are following the simple molecular orbital theory one, carbon monoxide molecule. Here is CO plus and here CO negative one. So bond order for CO is 3, for CO plus is 5 by 2, and for CO negative is about 5 by 2. So CO will have higher stretching frequency because you can see the bond order is greater, and so we require more vibrational frequency to vibrate that bond. The influence of reduced mass on the stretching frequency. As we discussed earlier, if the mass is greater, less vibrational frequency is required, and if the mass is small, then more vibrational frequency is required, because vibrational frequency is inversely proportional to reduced mass. So one would predict CH and OH stretching observation at higher frequencies than carbon-carbon single and carbon-oxygen stretching. So this is the infrared absorption frequencies of some bonds. Here is CH. If the carbon atom is sp hybrid state, then this is the vibrational frequency is required, because as that CH in case of sp hybridization has having more s character, so strength of bond is more, and so required more vibrational frequency. In case of sp2, slightly less vibrational frequency is required, while in case of sp3, then the vibrational frequency is slightly less than 3000 centimeter inverse. So this is about carbon oxygen bond, and this is about carbon oxygen bond. In this case, the carbon atom is sp3 one. So again, you can see that less is character, so less vibrational frequency is required. This is about the carbon-carbon double bond, carbon-carbon triple bond. You can see that here the carbon-carbon double bond, more is the strength and more is the vibrational frequency required. And if there is the increase in order, you can see that here in case of this, carbon-carbon triple bond is here. So, and here is the carbon nitrogen triple bond. So, obviously, strength is greater, so more vibrational frequency is required. So, this is a very important one, because most of the organic molecules is having carbonyl group. So, they contain the carbonyl group one. So, the focus of this Karmic group. So this Karmic group will have the different vibration frequency. If it is in aldehyde and ketose one, this is the vibration frequency required. In case of acid, this is the range. In case of acid anhydride, you can see that this is the range one. In case of ester, this is the range. And in case of amides, again you can see this is the range. So let us discuss about the bending vibration also. So as I told you earlier, for bending vibration, the least vibration frequency is required. So you can see that if in these molecules, the frequency required to bend is less. Again, in case of derivative of benzene, if it is monosubstituted one, you will get the peak in this region, two peaks in this region. This is due to the bending vibration one. And in case of ortho disubstituted, you will get one peak in this region one. And in case of meta disubstituted, you will get the peak in the, you will get the two peaks in these regions. While for para disubstituted, you will get the peak in this region. So this is the clear chart. This is a complete chart. We can say it is, though it is not the complete one, but it will give some idea about the functional group. Actually, it will give the idea about the frequency to vibrate some functional group. So this is OH. If it is free form, then more vibration frequency is required. If it is in bonded form, then less vibration frequency is required. Then again, form carbonyl group one, carbon carbon triple bond one, carbon carbon double bond one. Here is the more strength, more vibration frequency is required. Here is slightly less strength, less vibration frequency is required. And again, you can see that in case of carbon carbon single bond, if the carbon atom is sp3 hybridization state, less s character, so less vibration frequency is required. And this is again about triple bond region. Obviously, more strength, more vibration frequencies are required. Similarly, you can see that for carbon carbon single bond, carbon single bond. So, in for tradition, this is very, very important one. This will give the idea about the functional group present in the organic molecules one. And this is the very, very important reason you have to remember. So, how it works? It's very simple. IR source, then there will be sample, then there will be prism, and finally detector will be detected, and you will get IR spectrum. So this is the IR spectrum. This is the spectrum for an enzyme. You can see these are the peaks, and that is due to CS stretching, as well as you can see this is for bending. This is the peak about 650 centimeter inverse, clearly indicates that molecule may have carbon carbon double bond. Okay, so again this is one. You can see that this could be the CS stretching, and obviously it indicates it is slightly greater, so that carbon atom may be in sp2 hybridization state. So this is, could be the molecule for this IR spectrum. Again you can see n-pentane. For n-pentane you will get the peak in this region, that is about 3000 centimeter inverse. Okay, again you can say for CS1 you will get the peaks just below 3000 centimeter inverse. This is for bending vibrations. N-hexane, this is for N-hexane, sorry, you will get the peak in these regions. This is for 2-hexanone-1, it is clear. If you are getting the peak in this 1700 centimeter inverse, that clearly indicates there could be the presence of carbonic group. Again, you can see that this broad peak clearly indicates this molecule is having OH group. So, obviously, this could be the molecule. Thank you very much for watching this video.